Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Robotics and Automation Guru. This is Venkateshwarlu. Now I am going to discuss about PLC ladder programming by using virtual labs. Today topic is how to design and simulate logic gates. Now we'll go to virtual labs. As it is shown on the screen, I will choose programmable logic controller. On the left, we can see the branch name, electrical engineering. Here we can see the subject or lab name, programmable logic controller lab. And these are the list of experiments in this subject. I will give a brief introduction about virtual labs. After that, we'll go to simulation. Today, we will discuss about implementation of logic gates. In this page, you can see the aim, theory, simulator, procedure in a serial manner. For better understanding of the experiment, go through the theory. For theoretical information about logic gates, go through the table. It is given clearly. AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, exclusive OR gate, and their truth tables. You can go through all this information and mainly check the graphical symbols. These are the graphical symbols which are mainly used in ladder programming. Next, go through procedure for easy designing. Procedure. Before simulation, go through procedure. You can get step by step information how to design the logic gate. Now we'll go to simulator for simulation. Click here for simulation. As we can see, there are two vertical lines for power supply. This and this. This is horizontal rung. This is normally open. NO contact. This is normally closed NC contact. Both are used for input. This is output coil. Now I am adding rung. After this, adding two normally open NO contacts in series along with an output coil. So NO contacts. And next, output coil. Now, we have to address the inputs by I1, I2. And output as O1. After this, we'll go to compilation to check any errors. So compiled successfully, no errors. Next step is to supply power to the vertical lines in order to check the simulation. So then press on the run for power supply. Now we have to now we have power supply. As you can see, the green line, as per end logic, when all the inputs I1, I2 are high simultaneously, only then we will get high output. To give input, select toggled. So for one input high, then output is low. But when we give both inputs high simultaneously, then we'll get output high. So again, toggle. Okay. So end logic is simulated successfully. Now we'll design our logic in the same tab. Then we need to click on development mode for redesigning in the same tab. I will select another rung. To this, I will add two inputs. In end logic, NO contacts are placed in series, but in R logic, NO contacts we have to place in parallel. We have to create parallel path. So click here, click on the plus, then parallel path is created. So to create plus, to remove minus, click on minus, removed, click on plus, created. So parallel path is created, NO contacts are placed. Next, output coil also placed in other end. Now we will address the inputs as I3 and I4, as I1 and I2 are given for end inputs. I3. I4. Output. O2. Now we'll compile and check for design. So compiled successfully, no errors. Next, to provide power supply, we have to click on run and we have to check the working. So in end logic, when both are toggled simultaneously, then only output is high. But in R logic, if anyone, either I3 or I4, anyone high, then we'll get output O2 high. So anyone, so toggled. Now we see output O2, we got high. So R logic is designed and tested successfully. In next video, I will teach about all other logic gates, and in sequence, I will provide remaining experiments also, like timers and counters, one after another. If you have any doubts, let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video.